Now, I must tell you something that was not told you in the announcement. Something of which I'm very proud. First of all, I have had an asteroid named after me.
En primer lugar, he tenido un asteroide antes se le ha dado mi nombre.
In some place up there, asteroid Randy is moving around.
Y por algún lugar, allí arriba hay un asteroide Randy que se está moviendo.
Now mind you, it's very small.
Es muy pequeño.
But I had the great pleasure when they named it after me.
Pero fue así un gran placer que le dieran mi nombre.
2 years ago.
Hace 2 años.
I called Sir Arthur Clark, Arthur C. Clark.
Y hace 2 años llamé a Sir Arthur C. Clark.
And he lives in Sri Lanka.
Que vive en Sri Lanka.
And I said to him, Arthur, I'm very excited. They have named an asteroid after me.
Y le dije, Arthur, estoy muy emocionado de que hayan nombrado un asteroide con mi nombre.
And he said very quietly, he said, yes. It's quite a privilege. They named one after me 8 years ago.
Y él dijo muy bajito, sí, es un gran privilegio. Le dieron mi nombre a otro asteroide ya hace 8 años.
So I got on Google, which knows everything.
Así que busqué en Google porque lo sabe todo.
And I did some research.
Y hice algunas investigaciones.
I had the pleasure of calling Sir Arthur Clark back again and telling him something important. I said, Arthur, my asteroid is 17 kilometers on the side and yours is only 8.
Le dije, Arthur, mi asteroide tiene 17 kilómetros de diámetro y el tuyo solo tiene 8.
Arthur didn't speak to me for several weeks after that. But I'm sure he got over the terrible shock. Now I must explain what magicians have to do with this matter of perception. And one thing that magicians know that most other people aren't aware of.
Debo explicar lo que los magos saben en materia de percepción y aquellas cosas que los magos saben y las personas desconocen.
Now, magicians all know that people easily make assumptions. That is, with no evidence, they just see something and they decide something and they accept it.
Los magos saben que muchas personas realizan asunciones, es decir, sin evidencia ninguna, deciden algo y lo aceptan.
Now, I noticed when you people came in here, I was standing back there, and everybody came in, and then somebody sat down on the chair.
Me di cuenta cuando estaba observando cómo llegaba la gente, que todo el mundo entró a la habitación y se sentaron.
I didn't see anybody here test the chair to make sure that it was strong, see?
Y no vi que nadie se pusiera a comprobar la silla para ver si era lo suficientemente fuerte.
But since nobody fell on the floor, I guess they were all very strong.
Pero como nadie cayó al suelo, tengo que concluir que todas eran suficientemente fuertes.
But you see, that was an assumption that you made. You assumed that the chairs were adequate, they weren't broken, and you could sit down there easily. You made that assumption. So you have already made one assumption.
Pero podéis ver que todos asumisteis que las sillas eran fuertes, que no estaban rotas y que os podíais sentar con tranquilidad. Así que eso, esa es una asunción que ya llevasteis a cabo.
But I have already tricked you, you see, because you made another important assumption.
Pero yo os he engañado porque veis que habéis hecho otra asunción importante.
You believe that since I turned on this microphone and put it up against my mouth that I would do that.
Creísteis que estaba utilizando este micrófono porque lo estaba sosteniendo a la mano y acercándolo a mi boca, sin embargo no lo estaba utilizando, así que veis que todos realizáis asunciones de este tipo.
And some assumptions that you will make may cost you a lot of money, it may cost you your security, and if you make the wrong assumptions, it can cost you your life.
y algunas asunciones que realizáis pueden costarnos mucho dinero, mucha seguridad e incluso llegar a costarnos la vida.
Now, I must say at the same time that if you did not make assumptions in your life, some assumptions, you'll become catatonic.
Al mismo tiempo, debo decir que si no realizáis ningún tipo de asunción en la vida, estaríais totalmente catatónicos.
Now, I travel all over the world regularly, and I can assure you of one fact about the traffic. Traffic is regulated by red, green, and yellow lights. And red always means stop, green always means go, and yellow means go like hell.
Viajo alrededor de todo el mundo y he visto muchas señales de tráfico y en todos los lugares el rojo significa que hay que parar, el verde significa que hay que ir adelante y el amarillo significa que hay que ir a toda velocidad.
Now, I cross the traffic lights too, again, all over the world, and I look at the color of the lights, and when it turns green, I step off the walk onto the road.
Yo también observo estas señales de tráfico y cuando veo que se ponen verde, bajo de la acera y vuelvo en la carretera.
But I don't test the road because I know from past experience over many, many years that the road is not going to open up and slow.
Pero no me voy a comprobar la carretera porque a través de muchas pasadas experiencias sé que la carretera de repente no se va a abrir y va a parar.
I hope. So we have to take something on assumptions. We have to assume that certain things are going to work all the time. And that way we don't become catatonic and freeze up.
Así que debemos realizar algunas asunciones para funcionar y no volvernos catatónicos y quedarnos congelados.
Now, as you've been told, I'm from the United States of America, and we have had recently a thing called the Bush administration.
Como os han dicho, soy de Estados Unidos, de América, y hemos tenido recientemente lo que se llama la administración Bush.
I don't know how we survived that, but somehow we did.
No sé cómo lo sobrevivimos, pero de alguna manera lo hicimos.
One of the great sins of the Bush administration was that they constantly bashed science. They denied the value of science and they depended on prayer more than science.
Uno de los grandes pecados de la administración Bush fue que rebajaron el valor de la ciencia, que negaron el valor de la ciencia e insistieron en su lugar en el valor del reto.
Now, you must understand that there are two distinctly different kinds of science.
Debéis entender que hay dos tipos completamente diferentes de fe.
The first kind is what I call blind faith. That is based only on what people have told you when you were very small and when you were larger. That is blind faith, without any evidence.
El primer tipo es lo que llamo la fe ciega. Es la fe que acepta sin ningún tipo de evidencia lo que otra gente te dice, de pequeño y de mayor.
And the other kind is the kind of faith that I have, faith based on evidence.
Y el otro tipo de fe que yo tengo es una fe basada en la evidencia.
I suggest that you might want to think a good deal, very seriously, about accepting things on evidence and not on blind faith.
Sugiero que dediquéis vuestros pensamientos a aceptar cosas basadas en la evidencia y en la fe ciega.
Now, there's a better thing that I'll give you an anecdote here. What is the attitude of the average person, do you think, if they know that they're in a small town where they've never been before?
¿Puedes imaginar que puede ser la actitud de una persona promedio si está en una ciudad extraña la que no ha visitado antes?
And they know that there is somewhere near a riding academy, a place where people go to learn to ride horses.
Y saben que en las cercanías existe una academia de equitación, donde la gente aprende a montar a caballo.
And you're sitting with somebody else and you hear...
Y estáis sentados y escucháis ese ruido.
Now, I have a definition, by the way. In my new book that's coming out, I refer to woo-woos. Woo-woos are people who accept everything if it sounds attractive, but they don't need any evidence.
En mi nuevo libro, yo tengo un término que llamo woo-woos, que son las personas que aceptan algo si les resulta...
They find it attractive, yes. Now, you've been a relatively rational person, I hope. I would think so, looking at the moment, that they look very rational.
Vosotros sois, o espero, sea totalmente racionales, os miro, y me parece que sois algo racionales.
The rational person here around the corner.
Una persona racional que escuche ese sonido.
It's going to think right away, oh, that's probably a horse.
Va a pensar inmediatamente, es probablemente un caballo.
And then you have the other person who is a little bit woo, but not completely.
Y luego está otro tipo de persona, puede ser un poquito woo, pero no completo.
And that person may say, oh no, that must be a zebra.
Y esa persona dirá, oh no, debe ser una zebra.
And the real woo-woo has a different answer altogether. That the real woo-woo will say, oh, I've heard that. It must be a unicorn.
Woo-woo real dirá, he escuchado, debe ser un unicornio.
She's learning. Very good. Now, some years ago, I did an experiment with the idea of astrology. In fact, I've done this over the last 10 years. I've done it 3 times very successfully. And one of them was featured on an American science program called NOVA. The experiment consisted of going in front of a classroom about this size.
El experimento consistió en llegar a un aula de ese tamaño más o menos.
Now the people in the classroom knew who I was and what my reputation was.
Estas personas en este aula me conocían y sabían de mi reputación.
I told them, I have a friend who is a very famous astrologer, and if you give me your birth information, the date and the time and the city where it occurred, I will give that information to him, and next week he will give you accurate horoscopes.
Les dije, tengo un amigo que es un famoso astrólogo, y si me dais la información referente a vuestro nacimiento, el día, la hora, el lugar, entonces él la semana que viene os podrá dar horóscopos muy detallados.
And they were all excited. Well, this will be very good.
Y estaban muy emocionados.
And I took the information from them, wrote their names down, the dates, everything, and I took them home with me.
Anoté la información, sus nombres, las fechas, todo, y me la llevé a casa.
And the next week I came back with sealed envelopes, with gold seals on them, and the names very carefully inscribed on the outside, beautifully done.
Y la semana siguiente llegué con unos sellos, con unos sobres, sellados con unos sellos dorados y una caligrafía muy elegante.
And I handed out each one of them, this is yours, this is yours, and each person got their own horoscope.
Y se los di a cada uno, su persona, su horoscope correspondiente.
And I said, all right, I want everybody to open up their horoscope and read it to themselves, and then I'm going to ask you to rate it from 1 to 10. 10 being the very best, and 1 being very bad.
Y dijo, quiero que cada una de vosotros leáis vuestro propio horóscopo y a continuación haréis una evaluación, 1 a 10, con 10 siendo un horóscopo muy exacto y 1 siendo un horóscopo nada exacto.
So they all opened the envelopes very quickly, oh, yes, 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 and they started to read.
Todos abrieron los sobres rápidamente, empezaron a leer.
And I listened carefully.
Y escuché con mucho cuidado.
What I heard was, they were very excited.
Yes, we say, yeah,
I said, now, I want you to vote by putting up your hand. First of all, how many will vote just one?
Y quiero que votéis levantando la mano, les dije, ¿cuántos de vosotros vais a una votación de uno?
No hands went up.
Ninguna mano se levantó.
I went, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, no hands.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, ninguna mano.
Then at 8, 2 hands went up.
Dos manos cuando llegué al número 8.
At 9, almost all of them went up. And when I said 10, 2 or 3 hands went up. So the median score here would be very high. These people really agreed that this horoscope outlined exactly what they were all about.
Así que la evaluación del astrólogo resultó ser muy alta. Estas personas estuvieron muy de acuerdo en que los horóscopos habían acertado.
And then I said, each one of you, please, give your horoscope to the person behind you, and the person at the other end of the row, bring it up to the front. So everyone will have a different horoscope.
Y a continuación dije que cada una de las personas diera su horóscopo a la persona de la fila de atrás, y así sucesivamente, para que cada uno tuviera un horóscopo distinto del original.
And this was the best part for me.
Y esto fue la parte mejor para mí.
Because I heard the ooh and ah again, but in a different sound. It was not ooh, ah, it was ooh, ah.
Y escuché los ooh y ahs de nuevo, pero no con la misma entonación. Ya no era ooh, ah, sino ooh, ah.
And at the end, I saw them looking at one another very, very strangely, because they had all received exactly the same
horoscope.
Now, they had voted 8, 9, and 10, very high scores. And the interesting thing to me was that they had not found anything strange in the fact that 60% of what I wrote in that horoscope, because I wrote it myself, you see, 60% of what I said were things that are supposed to happen in the future.
Todos dieron una puntuación muy elevada a los horóscopos, pero sin prestar atención al hecho de que un 60% de la información, porque yo me la había inventado toda la información, eran eventos que sucederían en el futuro.
Now, how could you possibly give 90% score of 9 out of 10 or 10 out of 10 when 60% of it hasn't happened yet?
¿Cómo es posible dar una puntuación del 90% o del 100% si el 60% de la información todavía no ha ocurrido?
So I asked some of them individually why they scored so high.
Así que pregunté a algunas personas de manera individual por qué habían dado estas puntuaciones tan altas.
Now, one of the statements, I have the original statement right here in my book. One of the statements that I made in there was, very soon you will meet someone that you have never heard of before, but you will enjoy this person's friendship and you will benefit greatly from it.
Una de las cosas que ponía en el horóscopo era, conocerás a una persona con la que nunca has visto antes, pero la amistad de esta persona será algo que disfrutarás de manera inmensa.
And the reason that they accepted that and gave it such a high score, this is something they wanted to happen. Now many people have said to me, I think, Mr. Remy, that people just want to believe, but it's much more important than that. Most of these people need to believe.
Algunas personas me han dicho que lo que sucede es que la gente quiere creer, pero esto no es la verdad. La verdad es que necesitan creer.
So we see that it is the desire of people to be gullible and to believe things that don't have good evidence to support them if there are good things to hope for, and that is not living a real life.
Así que veis que es el deseo de las personas de tener credibilidad y de querer que les pasen cosas buenas, pero esto no es vivir en un mundo real.
Now, one thing that I have been fighting against, and my foundation, the James Randi Educational Foundation, has been actively fighting against, is homeopathy.
Algo por lo que he luchado, contra lo que he luchado activamente con mi fundación, James Randi Educational Foundation, es la homeopatía.
I am going to ask if there's anyone in this audience who can give me a very brief definition of what they think homeopathy really is.
Quiero saber si hay alguien entre el público que pueda darme una definición breve de qué consiste la homeopatía.
Not these two fellows, they're asleep.
No estos dos que están dormidos.
So, is there anyone there that can volunteer to give me a definition?
La homeopatía, a ver, busca un elemento que consigue igualar algo que falta en el cuerpo, lo disuelve en una serie de cantidades de agua, busca varias soluciones y a través de gotas, a través de perlas, equilibra el resto del organismo a través de la disolución de ese elemento que la homeopatía considera que a distintas personalidades le puede dar.
The homeopathy consists on identifying a missing element, an imbalance in the body, and then whichever the element is, they dilute it in water, and then and once it's diluted, they take these drops of water, and that's what you need to take to restore the balance in your body.
Homeopathy really is, when you know the truth about it, it is astonishing to know what it actually is.
Cuando se sabe la verdad sobre la homeopatía, resulta increíble saber de lo que realmente se trata.
I hope you're ready for this because it's quite astonishing.
Espero que estéis preparados porque os vais a quedar atónitos.
What they do is they take some sort of compound. It can be a chemical, it can be an herb, it can be any kind of pharmaceutical even.
Lo que hacen es tomar un compuesto y eso puede tratarse de una hierba o de un producto químico o un producto farmacéutico.
And they take one part of that and they put it in 10 parts of water.
Y toman una parte y la diluyen en 10 partes de agua.
And then they success it. This is a term that they made up. And it means shake it 10 times this way, 10 times this way, and 10 times this way.
Y a continuación la succession. Es un término que se inventaron ellos y quiere decir simplemente agitarlo 10 veces en esta dirección, 10 veces en esta y 10 veces en esta.
And remember, 10 is the magic word in homeopathy.
Y acordaos de que 10 es el número mágico en homeopatía.
Then they take one part of that mixture and they put it in 10 parts of water.
Y a continuación, esta mezcla toma una parte y la diluyen en otras 10 partes de agua.
So that solution is 1%, 1 in 100.
Así que esta solución es del 1%, es decir, una en 100 partes.
Now they call that a 2 solution because the number 100 has 2 zeros on it.
Llaman a esto una solución 2 porque el número 100 tiene 2 ceros.
And they continue to take one part of this and put it in another 10 parts of water to get a 3 solution, one part in 1,000.
Y a continuación toma una parte de esta solución y la ponen en otras 10 partes de agua para conseguir una solución del número 3.
Then they continue and continue and continue. Until they get up to about 10 to the power of 80.
Hasta que llegan a una potencia de 10 elevado a 80.
Now, let's go back just a little bit. Because when they got to the number 27,
porque cuando llegan al número 27,
they have reached what they call Avogadro's limit.
Han llegado al límite de Avogadro.
Avogadro was a very difficult man.
Avogadro era un hombre muy difícil.
Because he discovered when you got to 10 to the 27th,
porque descubrió que cuando llegas a 10 de la número 27,
there was a chance of there being only one molecule or atom of the original substance in that glass of water.
No había posibilidad de que existiera una molécula del elemento compuesto original en esa disolución de agua.
And then when you do it once more, 10 to the 28th, there's one chance in 10 of there being one molecule.
Y cuando llegas a 10 del valor 28, hay una oportunidad entre 10 de que exista esa molécula.
So you can see that by the time they have gotten to 10 to the 40th or the 50th or the 80th, as they like to use, there is not a possibility of there being one molecule or atom of the original substance in there.
Así que cuando llegan a 10 elevado a 40 o 50 o 80 que resulta utilizar, es completamente imposible que exista una molécula del elemento original.
Now, that doesn't bother them at all when you give them the mathematics of it, because they say, oh, it's okay, the vibrations of the original substance are still there.
Esto no les molesta en absoluto cuando les explican las matemáticas, porque dicen ellos que no importa, son las vibraciones del elemento original que todavía persisten.
Now, if you gave these people a big box like this, full of vibrations, they wouldn't know what they look like and they wouldn't know what to do with them.
Si se les diera a estas personas un contenedor así de grande, lleno de vibraciones, no sabrían ni lo que son ni lo que hacer con ellas.
Vibrations is a very popular word in quack medicine and in woo-woo.
Las vibraciones son un término muy popular en la medicina, no sé, falsa y en los grupos.
But the main thing you have to get ready for this now is not just vibrations, but quantum vibrations.
Pero ahora preparados, porque lo más importante no son las vibraciones, sino las vibraciones cuánticas.
Now, just to show you how silly this is, and then I will leave the subject, I must tell you about the most popular of the homeopathic medicines.
Ya para dejar este tema, quiero hablaros de lo que es la más popular de las medicinas homeopáticas.
It is called the silicone.
Se llama silicone.
And it is supposed to relieve the symptoms of influenza, flu.
Y se supone que alivia los síntomas de la gripe.
And I hope you won't fall off your chair if this is this, but it's true. It's made from duck livers.
Y espero que no os caigáis de las sillas al escuchar esto, pero están hechas de hígado de pato.
I don't know why. But we did some calculation and we find out that the ducks need not be very worried.
Pero hicimos unos cálculos y llegamos a la conclusión de que los patos no deben preocuparse.
Because with one duck liver, and that can be from a duck that died of old age. You can make enough silicone to fill the solar system with the sun at the center and the orbit of Pluto, which used to be a planet, at the outside. Now that's a lot of pills.
Yes, so much.
And only one duck had to die. But then, in my philosophy, ducks don't have a very good future. They don't write poetry or music, so I'm not too worried.
Pero no me preocupan mucho los patos porque no tienen un futuro muy brillante, no escriben filosofía ni poesía, así que no me preocupan.
Now, I hope this has made it evident to you just how very silly homeopathy is.
Espero que esto se haya hecho evidente, la tontería que es la homeopatía.
Now, I did a very comprehensive test of homeopathy with the BBC, the British Broadcasting Corporation, and the Royal Society in the UK.
Yo ya hago unos tests intensivos de la homeopatía en colaboración con la BBC y la Royal Society en Reino Unido.
And I offered the homeopaths in England the $1 billion prize that our foundation offers for any proof of any woo.
Y ofrecí a los homeópatas el premio de $1 million que nuestra fundación ofrece para aquellos que puedan demostrar cualquier woo.
Now, they conducted the test, not I.
Ellos llevaron a cabo el test, yo no lo hice.
With the Royal Society watching very carefully to make sure it was properly done.
Con la Royal Society vigilando cuidadosamente que fuera llevado a cabo apropiadamente.
And the task was very simple. All they had to do was tell whether a bottle of water was homeopathic or was ordinary plant water.
La tarea fue muy simple. Lo único que tenían que hacer era distinguir entre dos botellas de agua cuál era homeopática y cuál era simplemente agua.
They failed completely.
Fracasaron por completo.
They did not win the $1 million. But as soon as they heard that the results were negative, they said, well, there was something wrong with the test.
No ganaron el millón de dólares, pero tan pronto escucharon que habían fracasado, dijeron que les había algo que no estaba bien en el test.
So I asked them to do it again, and I heard nothing. No answer.
Así que les dije que lo hicieran de nuevo, y no he escuchado nada, ninguna respuesta.
Now, again, this should prove to you that homeopathy is absolutely ridiculous, but that $1 million offer still stands. It is constantly before the public and before the scientific world and before the homeopaths. All they have to do is prove that they can tell the difference between ordinary water and homeopathic water. Anyway, biologically, spectroscopy, chemically, I don't care. Anyway, any scientific method they want to use, including medical methods, by testing their medicine on human beings, and if they can prove that, they get $1 billion.
Espero que esto haya demostrado que la homeopatía no resulta seria, pero el premio de $1 million sigue ahí para el público, para los científicos, para los homeópatas, que puedan demostrar de cualquier manera, incluyendo medios químicos, espectroscopía, tests con pacientes humanos, cualquier método, si lo pueden demostrar, tendrán $1 million.
Well, now, one thing I did not tell you about homeopathy, and you should know this to have a complete education, that the more dilute the medicine is, the higher that number is, they say, the more powerful the medicine is.
Hay una cosa que no se dice sobre la homeopatía, pero es importante para que la comprendáis al completo, y es que a mayor disolución, es decir, cuanto mayor sea el número, dicen que más efectiva resulta la medicina.
And since they will make medicine up to dilution of 5,000 times, that is very valuable. But they say it's perfectly harmless that you can't die of an overdose.
Y ellos hacen medicinas que están diluidas hasta 5,000 veces, pero también advierten que son completamente inofensivas en el sentido de que no es posible la sobredosis.
One unfortunate gentleman in Florida, in Fort Lauderdale, as a matter of fact, did die of an overdose.
Un desafortunado caballero en Fort Lauderdale, en Florida, sí se murió de una sobredosis.
He forgot to take the medicine.
Se olvidó de tomar la medicina.
If you get zero bills, that's infinitely strong, you see. Think about it. Okay.
Si
that's probably the best.
Si tomas una dosis de cero, es infinitamente potente. Tenemos una sobre materia y ya es suficiente para ese tema.
Now, I must say that in the United States I have an admission to make and I'm rather embarrassed by it.
En los Estados Unidos tengo una misión de la cual estoy algo profundamente avergonzado.
We don't use the metric system.
No utilizamos el sistema métrico.
The only other country in the world that does not use the metric system at all is a very small country about this big in South America.
El único país en el mundo que no utiliza el sistema métrico es un país así de pequeño en Sudamérica.
And the whole United States of America, you see? Now, I asked a person in the United States Congress that I know very well, I said, Congresswoman, what do you think the reason for that is? Why don't we use the metric system? And she said, oh, it's a very easy answer to that.
Así que le pregunté a una persona del Congreso de Estados Unidos, pero ¿cuál es la razón por la cual no utilizamos el sistema métrico? Y ella me respondió, hay una respuesta muy simple.
And this really surprised me, and it will probably surprise you too. She said that they are constantly, all the senators and the congressmen in the United States are constantly being visited by lobbyists, that is, people who represent different products and different organizations, and they go to Washington to try to talk them into doing something or not doing something.
Y esto es porque los miembros del Congreso y senadores continuamente reciben la visita de miembros de los lobbies que son representantes de uno u otro producto que les insisten en que hagan una u otra cosa.
And they say, oh, you should not use the metric system, Senator or Congressman. You must not use the metric system because there's a very good reason for that.
Y dicen, Senador, no se puede utilizar el método métrico, el sistema métrico, y hay una razón muy importante para ello.
It was invented by atheists.
Fue inventado por ateos.
And they say, the worst kind of atheists.
Dicen, el peor tipo de ateos.
French atheists. After the revolution, you see.
Después de la revolución francesa.
And so the congressman say, well, I'll do that some other time. Not today, I'm very busy. So we are still measuring things in inches and feet and yards and rods, and it goes on and on, and it is a stupid system, the English system, a really stupid system, but we are stuck with it in the United States of America. I congratulate you for using the metric system.
Así que todavía pedimos las cosas en yardas y pies y yardas y todo tipo de medidas estúpidas, así que quiero felicitaros por utilizar el sistema
métrico. Now I must tell you that senators and scientists and very prominent people are not much smarter than the woos out there in many cases.
Y debo deciros que en muchos casos los senadores y los científicos y el público no son mucho más listos.
I was in my office and I got a call from my assistant who said, oh, there's a fellow on the telephone. He's a physicist from Lawrence Livermore Laboratories. Lawrence Livermore Laboratories. And it's a very, very famous set of laboratories, all physicists, very, very well-educated people.
Estos son los famosos de laboratorios de física, en los que estos físicos son gente que tiene un alto nivel de educación.
So I said, I'll speak to him, and I picked up the phone, I said, this is James Randi, and who am I speaking to, and he gave me his name.
Así que les cogí el teléfono y le dije, yo soy James Randi, ¿con quién estoy hablando?
So I said, how can I help, conductor? And he said, well, I must tell you that you have lost the million-dollar prize.
Le dije, ¿en qué puedo ayudarle? Y él me respondió, tengo que decirle que ha perdido el premio del millón de dólares.
Of course, I was very worried, yeah, sure.
Estaba muy preocupado, claro que sí.
And he told me, he said, we have a man here in our office at the laboratory. His well, I won't give you his name, but it's not a name you would know anyway. But he came from Israel, the same place that Marie Miller came from, and he can do something which is supernatural.
Tenemos a este hombre aquí en nuestras oficinas, en los laboratorios, y es un hombre que viene de Israel, que es el mismo lugar de referencia de Miller, y es capaz de hacer algo que es supernatural.
So I said to my assistant, you know, pick up the phone and listen. He picked up the phone. And I said, what can this man do? And he said, well, he sent us to go to the grocery store and buy a box of matches, wooden matches.
Así que puse a mi ayudante en el teléfono y yo en la otra línea y pregunté qué es lo que puede hacer este hombre. Y dijo, bien, este hombre nos mandó al supermercado a comprar una caja de cerillas de madera.
Said, but we were scientists and we don't just do a simple thing like that, we do it
scientifically.
So they went to the store and they bought 24 of these in a big package.
Así que fueron a la tienda y compraron 24 cajas de cerillas en un paquete grande.
This is science. And they took the boxes out and they numbered them 1, 2, 3, all the way up to 24.
Así que sacaron las cajas de cerillas del paquete y numeraron todas del 1 al 24.
Then they went to the computer and they generated a random number between 1 and 24. And they selected that box.
Y seleccionaron esa caja.
They threw the other boxes away.
Se deshicieron de las otras 23.
And then they took that box and they examined it under spectroscope, polarized light, red and blue light, infrared, ultraviolet, all kinds of observations to make sure it was a real box of matches.
Y tomaron esa caja de cerillas y la analizaron con espectroscopía, con luz polarizada, luz ultravioleta, luz infrarroja y todo tipo de exámenes para asegurarse de que era realmente una caja de cerillas.
Now at that point I thought I knew what trick the man was going to do, so I signaled to Andrew, my assistant, and Andrew said, yes, he went to the library to get a book by Mark Berger called Impromptu Magic Tricks.
En ese momento yo pensaba que sabía cuál era el truco, así que le señalé a mi ayudante Andrew para que fuera a la librería a buscar un libro de Martin Gardner que se llamaba Impromptu Magic Tricks.
Now, Andrew is a magician too, you see, so he understood what the trick probably was. He went and got the book, he found the page number in the book, and he gave it to me on a piece of paper, and I signaled to him like this, very clearly. And he made a photocopy of that page and went over to the fax machine at that time.
Y antes que su mago también sabía cuál era probablemente este truco, así que abrió el libro y lo enseñó por la página y yo le hice unos gestos para que hiciera una fotocopia de esa página del libro.
And I said to the scientist on the telephone, do you have a fax number? And he gave me the fax number.
Le pregunté al científico por teléfono si tenía un número de fax y me dio el número de fax.
And Andrew dialed up the fax number.
Y Andrew marcó el número.
And I said, just hold. And I asked, what does he do with this box of magic? He said, he places it on the back of his hand.
Y le pregunté, ¿qué es lo que hace con esta casa de cerillas?
And then he signals, and the box stands up on the back of his hand. And then he signals again, the box goes down again. Fantastic, see? And all he has to do is say, up, and it goes up. And then down, and it goes down. Now, I don't know how he does. Now, this is what he was doing, this very simple trick. So I said to Andrew, press the button, and he sent this page from the book to the scientist in California.
Y eso es un truco muy simple, así que le dije a Andrew, dale al número y mandó esta página del fax al laboratorio de California.
Now how this trick is done, ladies and gentlemen, it's a children's trick. It's very simple. This is what you do, you simply leave the box partially open like this, and you lay it on the back of your hand, you close the box, but you pinch some of the skin on the back of your hand in the box, you see.
Lo que hay que hacer es abrir ligeramente la caja de cerillas, colocarlo en la mano de forma que pellizque un poquito de la piel.
And this, by tightening up the skin, it stands up in the back of
the hand.
Then you relax it again, and it comes up again, and up and down, and up and down. Here's a souvenir. See? Who's your guest? Souvenir. Now, I listened on the telephone, and the scientist said, oh yes, it's coming over the factory, and click, and he started to read it. He said, the match box trick, yes. Mm-hmm. I took the match box, and said, hello, no, I'm still here, I'm sure, okay. Hello? He hung up the phone. We never heard from Lawrence Livermore Laboratories again. This is a case of a scientist believing that he has a PhD. He knows everything as soon as he gets that diploma from the university.
El científico me dijo por teléfono, sí, sí, aquí llega el fax, lo voy a leer. Ajá, lo estoy leyendo. Sí, sí, un momento. Y luego el sonido de colgarse el teléfono. Y este es el caso de un nunca más os volví a saber nada. Este es el caso de un científico que por tener un doctorado pensaba que no se le podía engañar.
Now I must scold the public in general, and I will now, not saying that you are guilty of this, but I must give you a scolding, really.
Debo regañar al público en general, no decir que os queráis todo, pero sí quiero regañar un poco.
Magicians are not scientists, not many men, some of them are, but not many.
Los magos no son científicos, unos pocos y los otros no muchos.
But we do have special expertise on how intelligent people, well-educated people, can be fooled by charlatans.
Pero sí tenemos unos conocimientos especiales sobre cómo personas y personas inteligentes pueden llevarse engaño con los charlatanes.
Now I ask you to imagine this in your mind.
Quiero que os imaginéis esto con vuestras mentes.
Suppose that you're in a strange city where you don't know very many things about the city. You're a stranger there, and you're walking down the street, and you see a theater there, and it says, Hamlet, by William Shakespeare.
Imaginaos que llegáis a una ciudad extraña en la que no conocéis nada, pero veis un teatro en el que se anuncia Hamlet, de William Shakespeare.
And you say to yourself, oh, I don't have time, I think I can go into the theater, the show's going to start, and you buy a ticket and you go inside.
Y miras el reloj, dices que tienes tiempo, así que compras una entrada y entras en el teatro.
Now this is a very fine play, a very exciting play. I love it, I've seen it many times. It's started with Hamlet, as a matter of fact. Hamlet is a very, very excellent play. And suppose that the visitors to the city sits there and watches the whole play and is very pleased.
Esta es una obra excelente que me encanta, que la he visto en muchos idiomas. Pues imaginaos que el visitante de esta ciudad ve esta obra y se queda muy contento.
And at the end of the play, you know what they do. They close the curtain and they open it up and all of the actors come out to take a bow.
Y al final de la obra ya sabes lo que pasa. Que se cierra la cortina y se abre otra vez y salen todos los actores a saludar.
And there's much applause, of course.
Y hay muchos aplausos.
And then the final actor who comes out is the actor who played the part of Hamlet. That's the star of the whole show.
Y el último actor que sale es el actor que hizo de Hamlet, que es la estrella del espectáculo.
Now, I ask you to imagine that the actor comes out and takes off the blonde wig and then takes his bow, and they give him applause.
Y quiero que os imaginéis que el actor sale a saludar, que se quita la peluca rubia, que saluda, que aplaude.
And then he holds up his hand for silence and says, ladies and gentlemen, I must tell you something. I'm not just an actor, I actually am a prince of Denmark.
Y en ese momento alza su mano para pedir silencio y dice, señoras y caballeros, quiero decirles que no soy solamente un actor, sino que además soy el príncipe de Dinamarca.
Now you know that's not true, and you should be insulted by this. You should be saying, this man thinks we're all fools.
Y en ese momento piensas, esto no es verdad. Te sientes insultado. Piensas, este hombre debe creerse que somos todos tontos.
But if that man was not insulted and booed and told to get off the stage and such, that's very much like what people are doing in the public these days. There are people out there that you pay money to, they tell you that they can tell your future by examining the stars and the planets, that they can look at your hand and they can read your future in your hand, or they look in tea leaves or coffee grounds, I don't care, and tell your future. Are you insulted by that? You should be insulted by that.
Y esto que sucede cuando el actor se encuentra en esta situación y el público lo abuchea y le piden que se vaya del escenario, es lo mismo que ocurre cuando otras personas dicen poder leer el futuro en los astros o en las líneas de la mano o en las hojas de té o en los pozos de café, y estas personas deberían decírseles, deberían abucheárseles de la misma manera.
And do not decide for a minute, any of you, oh, I'm too smart, I'm too well educated, I'm too sensible to be fooled. You can be fooled.
No penséis en ningún momento que yo soy demasiado listo o tengo una alta educación y no se me puede engañar, porque sí, se puede engañar.
Now I'm going to demonstrate that, I hope, I'm going to try to show you the demonstration of what we call mentalism. This is tricks, magician's tricks. There are tricks, but they appear to be done with the mind.
Para ello voy a demostrar un tipo de magia que se llama mentalismo, que son trucos, trucos mágicos, trucos de magia, pero que aparecen realizarse con la mente.
Now, I spoke to, when the audience was coming in today, I was out there and I saw the audience coming in, and I spoke to a young man who offered to help me in this demonstration, and he is in the audience someplace. Where, there you are, over there. I didn't get your name. What's your name? Sorry?
Pedro.
That's an easy name. I like that name. Okay. Pedro, would you stand up? Now, I'm going to tell this audience what we did out of the lobby here, okay? And if I make any mistakes, you tell me right away. Now, Pedro is only cooperating with me to this extent. He is helping me prepare the demonstration. Now, I don't speak your language, unfortunately. I apologize for that. But there was a travel magazine. A travel magazine that dealt with travel. I believe that's what it was.
No, no hablo tu idioma malamente, pero había una revista que era una revista de viajes.
Yeah, and it had 108 pages. Is that correct?
Okay. Y tenía 108 páginas.
Now I asked Pedro. I simply said, "You go over there, and I will stand over here." In fact, I stood with this lady, and we turned our back. I simply said to Pedro, "Name any number between 1 and 108, correct?"
Y le pedí a Pedro, le dije que se colocara en un lugar, y yo me aparté, porque es un lugar diferente, y le pedí que mencionara un número entre el 1 y el 108.
And you did that, correct? Right? But when you turned to the page, it was all photographs. There were no words. I wanted a page with a lot of words, correct? Right? And we had to look through until we found a page that was all about all words, afterwards maybe, I don't know. And that's what we did, am I correct?
Pero cuando lo hicimos, resulta que solo había fotografías en esa página. De hecho, la revista tenía muchas hojas que eran solamente fotografías.
Right. And then I said, now I had my back turned away from you, and so did Susanna. And I said, I want you to simply select any word on the page. Run your finger around and select any word on the page, but not a simple word like am or but or something like that. And I asked you to take a good word, a good informative word, and you did that, am I correct? Oh, I forgot to ask, do you remember the word? Oh, good, I'm glad to hear that. Because I hate when I say, the word is so-and-so, and they look at it and say, oh, I really hate that. But now,
cuando encontramos una página con texto, entonces me volví a apartar, y también se apartó Susana, y te pedimos que buscaras una palabra, que no fuera una preposición, un artículo, sino una palabra con contenido. Y que te acordaras de la palabra. Y esto es importante porque a veces las personas no se acuerdan de la palabra y entonces no se acuerdan del grupo.
And you have not told anybody what the word was. And I then asked you to tear that page out of the magazine, fold it up, and put it in your pocket. And you did that, am I correct? You have it there?
Y te pedí que recordaras la palabra y a continuación que arrancaras la hoja de la revista y te la doblaras y te la guardaras en el bolsillo.
So do you agree with me that you are the only person in the whole universe that knows what that word is?
¿Estás de acuerdo conmigo que tú eres la única persona de todo el universo que sabe cuál es esa palabra?
Okay, now I'm going to step to this big whiteboard here. It's a big board, all right. I could use a small one. I think that's a big, they're very generous. They have a lot of money. I am going to begin writing on this board. And I won't look at you, Pedro, because if I look at you, there are two ways that you could look back at me. You would either go like that because it's correct, or you'd be going like that because it's incorrect, okay? So I'm not going to look at you because I could get body feedback that way. I will start writing. Now again, I don't speak your language, so let's just hope that we can make this now.
Voy a escribir en este tablón. No quiero mirarte para que no me des información sobre si voy por el camino correcto.
I presume this is a Spanish word because it's a Spanish magazine.
Esta debe ser una palabra española porque la revista está en español.
This is very strange. This is not right. Here. Idiots, they're stupid. Don't ever think that.